Right, so we've got everything sorted, and most importantly, I should have said, welcome to part. What part is it? Part four. Sorry, I had to have a little think then. So here we are, here's the Hurricane, she's all done, painted, well, not painted up, masked up. Don't think I'm going to bother with the bottom, but I think I might have to do the intake there. I just realised I'm done there, so I'll do a minute. Based on what we've done, for the paint we're going to use, I'm going to put the dark brown camo on first. I'm using this colour, this is Mr. Hobby H72, and this is a very nice colour. And I mixed it with a tiny little bit of white and a bit of retarder. So there you are. And that's it, that's all we're using for the base camo. We're going to airbrush it as well, that's another important thing. So, yeah, it's not going to take that long. So I'm going ahead and airbrush that and then see where we go then.
6.5 hours later.
Right, so painted it the dark brown Hurricane, and I did use this colour, and I did mix it with a bit of white. Now I want to point out something if it's not picked up on this camera. This is sprayed in how would you put it? A light colour. It is a light brown, don't get me wrong, but the way the sun is positioned at the minute, there's hardly no sun whatsoever, so you can't really see the light on it, and plus it's gonna change overnight, of course, the brown a bit. So that's really it. I'm not sure, I'm just gonna turn this light on, see if there's any. There. See if there's any difference in that or not at all, I don't know. But either way, it's going to be. It's in a light brown, don't get me wrong. And once you've put the gloss varnish on and deckled it and stuff like that, it will go light. You see, I was trying to get it more to light of like the brown for the. What's it called? The Defiance, sorry, I can't think of the name for that colour. That was quite difficult because this one's had about, just try to look for the paint, it's not in there, it's down here. It's had about 5 different sorts of colours on, both not the right colour, both changed, too light, too little, I don't know, but that's how it goes. But at the minute, I'm happy with this colour, it's fine, I'm going to leave it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off with painting it. Now I have airbrushed this over like that, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint it in the dark green, which is the Revel 68. Now, I prefer this paint than to any other paint I've ever used. It's absolutely like really spot on colour. So there you are. So I'm just going to mix a bit of this. I'm just going to test it out. So I've got the colour call out here. And we're just, of course, using this to show what we're going to do, like that. Bit more up there. Then just down here, like that, and I'm just going to coat over where it's gone. So this is going to be a very, very long progress. So that's that, so at least we've got the main position of where the colour's going to go. Across there, fill that in. So that's the, it's the natural green camo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in time-lapse, colour the rest in, colouring book, fill the rest in and see where we get on from there. Here we are, we've got everything painted on it, the Hurricane, and I have to say it does look a nice colour now. Some people are going to say, is the brown a bit too light? It is a bit too light, but on the plus side is when this gets a gloss varnish, which we're going to do now, it's going to become much darker. And that's kind of what I want, to be honest. Because, well, you need the gloss varnish or put the decals on, but there you are. So, get our nice fuzzy brush, that's what I called it. And get our Humbrol gloss varnish in here. Now, I want to mention that I'm using an old pen to hold this. Now, you can use whatever you want, but this is a quick get together what I've just done. So, I'll just smooth it out if you haven't used this before. It's very a bit thin over there, over the gum bays. Over like that. Across there, let's say you can't get the picture, just put a gloss varnish coat on it. Now you can do it sprayed or sprayed for an airbrush or a can, but I've tried both, and to be honest, I've got to stick with the brush effect. I'm sorry if there's going to be some people out there saying, oh, that's wrong and stuff like that, but it's just my choice of how I like to do things. Now, number one thing, never try and get hair on this, like I've just done so there. Like that. Just never get hair on the model because, of course, then you won't be able to get off again. And it's just reappeared again. Have you gone? No, he hasn't. He's still there. Now he's gone. There you go. Again, just coat over there. Like so. And the coat across there. So I can say, I'm just going to go ahead and finish this off. But really, is that hair on there? No. No, sorry, I thought it was, but it's not. So like I say, this is kind of pretty much done now for painting wise. So what we're going to do is we're going to end the program here, or the episode, whatever. And we're going to start on the next subject, which is the decaling and weathering, of course. Then finally get on with the build then. Right, so with that, I thank you very much for watching. I think we can continue in a minute. I shall see you all later. So once again, cheers and goodbye for now.